Today we are talking about the three-member Jammu Kashmir interlocutor panel which has gone to Srinagar. All of us know that this panel has just made a beginning. It has reached Srinagar yesterday, Saturday. And on reaching, Dilip Padgaonkar ji, jo is three-member panel ki chairman hai aur head hai, informally press ko udhar meet kiya hai aur us informal meeting mein aise comments unke apne man ki baat hai ya to unki brief hai mujhe malum nahi ho rahi hai. He has given such statement which has been reported in all the newspapers today. And for our benefit today, here, I'll just read out two important lines which has been mentioned by him. He says in this so-called informal chat with the media, we are here, I'm quoting him, we are here to look for a permanent solution to the Kashmir issue. But a permanent solution is not possible without the involvement of Pakistan. This is exactly what Mr. Dilip Padgaonkar has said. And furthermore, probably clarifying his statement, he has also said any attempt to have a comprehensive solution, any attempt to have a comprehensive solution without Pakistan's involvement is not possible. Pakistan has to be involved, unquote. So the statement that he's made, I guess, just not once, in clarification, a second time too, clearly states something which we are not very sure was a part of the brief given to him. Is this part of the brief which the Union government has given the panel of interlocutors? Ye baat kya unke diye gaye charchamshaniya baaton ka zikr karte hue ye statement diya hai kya? Ye unko interlocutors ko jo brief diya hai usme ek amsh hai kya? Agar वो अंश बनते हैं, फिर हमें डर है कि इस प्रोसेस को इंटरनेशनलाइज करने के लिए एक कोशिश है. इफ दिस इंडीड वॉज पार्ट ऑफ द ब्रीफ गिवन टू द इंटरलॉक्यूटर्स, इट समवेयर गिव्स अस द फीलिंग दैट इट इज बीइंग इंटरनेशनलाइज्ड. दिस प्रोसेस, दिस एंटायर प्रोसेस इज गेटिंग अननेसेसरीली इंटरनेशनलाइज्ड. What is the Pakistan dimension that Mr. Dilip Padgaonkar is referring to? He's mentioned it. I have not read that line as a quotation, but it has been reported that there is a Pakistan dimension to this. We just want to ask, what is the Pakistan dimension that this interlocutor is talking about? Has he overstepped his brief? If it is not part of the brief given to the panel, and if he has overstepped it, we from the BJP demand that the Prime Minister's office, the PMO, please give a clarification. The PMO should come out immediately, because after all, the panel has gone to Jammu and Kashmir. In Srinagar, from yesterday, they've started their job, and this is the first time after being appointed the panel has reached Srinagar, and they're going to be there for at least this leg, we are told, for a whole week. And if during this whole week they're starting their, I think, very difficult and sensitive assignment, in this note it raises a lot of questions. So therefore we demand that the PMO immediately give us a clarification, give the nation a clarification, if Mr. Patgaonkar's brief indeed it was to say what he said. It also gives us an impression that he is only legitimizing or rationalizing Pakistan's stand on this unfinished agenda on Kashmir, which we repeatedly hear. There is an unfinished agenda for Pakistan on Kashmir issue. This kind of a comment is only rationalizing that kind of a stand. Furthermore, it gives us the feeling that the panel is already taking the Hurriyat angle. Are all these kind of things intended somewhere? Unknowingly has it been said, or is it a comment which has been essentially an outcome of the brief that they have received? I think there is a lot of questions coming out of this informal chat that Mr. Patgaonkar has had in Srinagar yesterday. Isliye hum mang karte hain ki Prime Minister's office se turant ek clarification nikalna chahiye ki kya ye briefing mein ek amsh tha internationalizing the process or what is it? There is a need for the PMO to intervene and give the nation a clarification on this matter immediately. ये सब ना एक पद्धति के रूप में चल रहे क्या, ऐसे हमें मन में आशंका आ रही है. एक तरफ से पहले कांग्रेस की जनरल सेक्रेटरी इतने हंगामा जब जम्मू एंड कश्मीर में हुआ, उस समय जब बाकी राज्यों में हम बोलते हैं लॉ एंड ऑर्डर ऑर्डर सिचुएशन बिगड़ गए, चीफ मिनिस्टर क्या कर रहे हैं, उस समय कांग्रेस की जनरल सेक्रेटरी बोलते हैं नहीं नहीं प्लीज उनको ज्यादा टाइम दे दीजिए, एक सर्टिफिकेट देने लायक स्टेटमेंट है वो. तुरंत सर्टिफिकेट और टाइम मिलने के बाद जम्मू कश्मीर के चीफ मिनिस्टर श्री उमर अब्दुल्ला ने ऐसे उनके असेंबली में एक स्पीच दिए हैं जिसमें बहुत चर्चा हुए, आप सबको मालूम है. ऐसे स्पीच जो कश्मीर की मोहल्ले में भी देने लायक नहीं है, सेपरेटिस्ट की बात सामने आई. इट वॉज ऑलमोस्ट एस इफ दैट स्पीच इन द असेंबली ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर वॉज रिटन स्क्रिप्टेड बाय एक्सट्रीमिस्ट सेपरेटिस्ट. इट वॉजंट अ स्पीच विच वी वुड अंडरस्टैंड अ चीफ मिनिस्टर हु हैज बीन इलेक्टेड एज पर अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल राइट्स could speak at all. So that is the second. Then you have the separatists come to Delhi even after the announcement of interlocutors has been made, and on the one hand they reach on a Saturday there, just a day or two before that you have separatists sitting with the intellectuals who support Naxals who are also questioning our constitution, all together on a platform and right in our national headquarters in Delhi. They give such speech which are objectionable and verges on sedition. So if you look at it one after the other, there are events happening which give us a feeling that on the one hand the separatists are going away scot-free with whatever they want to speak and say, and if there is a union government appointed team going there to discuss this matter, to have wide-ranging discussions with all sectors, segments of society, is the interlocutor himself saying something which is beyond his brief? That is where there is a need for us to ask the Prime Minister's office to come out clean on what was the brief given to the interlocutor's panel which has gone there.
Ma'am, the Army Chief has said that diluting the Armed Forces Special Powers Act is in fact pandering to the requests of the separatists. Who would you hold responsible for any dilution, the center or the state government?
See, very clearly we have mentioned that there should not be any dilution of the Armed Forces Special Powers Act, because the moment you dilute it, it is like sending the army with both their hands tied behind their backs. And that is not going to help the situation at all. So our position on the Armed Forces Special Powers Act is very clear. We do not want a dilution. But at this stage, of course, directly answering your question, it would be under the purview of the center. It is they who have to take responsibility for it.
Madam, mera sawal tha ki Pak occupied Kashmir ki jahan tak baat hai, wo bina Pak ke involvement ke kaise us par aap baat kar rahe hain? To Pakistan ne kaha ki unko shamil karna padega, isme kaun problem se mila
rahe? Problem isliye aa rahi hai ki Jammu and Kashmir mein jitne bhi problems unke nagrik जनता फेस कर रहे हैं, उसके वजह से जो भी प्रॉब्लम्स उधर आप 100 डेज देके जब इतने सारे लोग तकलीफ में थे, कर्फ्यू भी लगा गया है, स्कूल्स बंद था, इन सब के कारण क्या है, क्या हो रही है उधर, ये इन सब विषयों के ऊपर जानकारी लेने के लिए और जनता से बात करने के लिए एक टीम जा रही है। ये भारत देश के एक अंग है जम्मू एंड कश्मीर। हमारे नागरिक से बात करने के लिए हमारे इंटरलॉक्यूटर्स जब जाते हैं, इसमें विदेश का रोल क्या हो रही है, कहां से आते हैं रोल किसी और का? सो एट दिस स्टेज इंटरलॉक्यूटर्स हु गो देयर टू अंडरस्टैंड द प्रॉब्लम आर टॉकिंग टू द सिटीजंस एंड देयरफॉर वी हैव अ डिफिकल्टी एंड वी वांट द पीएम टू एक्सप्लेन इफ दैट इज पार्ट ऑफ द ब्रीफ गिवन।
डू यू डिमांड हिज रिकॉल?
एट दिस स्टेज वी वांट द पीएम टू से टेल अस if this is part of the brief given.
Bade prashn Gujarat se juda hua hai. Gujarat mein bhajpa ki zabardast panchayat chunav mein jeet ke baad wahan ke jo congress ke senior leader hai wo pradesh adhyaksh ko istifa de rahe hain ke aadhar par. Aapko kya lagta hai ki puri tarah se congress wahan par barabar haar chuki hai?
Congress CBI और अदर इन्वेस्टिगेशन एजेंसीज को दुरुपयोग करते हुए गुजरात में उनके पकड़ रखने के लिए बहुत ही बार कोशिश करते आए। सोहराबुद्दीन मामले में अमित शाह जी जो होम मिनिस्टर को इंट्रोगेशन के नाम में अरेस्ट करके रखे हैं, मगर बहाना ये बोलते हैं कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑर्डर को सीबीआई और इन्वेस्ट एसआईटी आगे बढ़ा रही है। वही सुप्रीम कोर्ट के ऑर्डर था कि आंध्र प्रदेश में भी जाइए, उधर अगर एनकाउंटर है कुछ करो उसके ऊपर भी। अगर सुप्रीम कोर्ट के ऑर्डर पालन करने वाले हैं कांग्रेस, क्यों आंध्र प्रदेश में कुछ एक्शन नहीं कर रहे हैं? दूसरा, सुप्रीम कोर्ट की ऑर्डर ही था अफसल गुरु को फांसी सजा देना, उसको 2-3 साल तक दिल्ली सरकार उसके ऊपर कुछ कार्रवाई नहीं किए, आगे उस फाइल को मूवमेंट करने के लिए नहीं दिए। ये सब कांग्रेस की चाल है। वेरी क्लियरली दे वे यूजिंग इन्वेस्टिगेशन एजेंसीज टू ट्राई एंड सी इफ दे कैन गेट अ होल्ड इन गुजरात, और गुजरात की जनता पूरे कांग्रेस को मुंह तोड़ जवाब देते आ रहे हैं, देते आ रहे हैं। कटलल विच वॉज कंसिडर्ड टू बी ए कंप्लीट फोर्ट्रेस ऑफ द कांग्रेस हैज बीन थ्रश्ड। कांग्रेस इज डिफीटेड सो बैडली एंड आफ्टर दैट 6 म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशंस वेर यू हैड 2/3 मेजोरिटी एंड मेनी ऑफ देम हैव इवन नियरली 60-65% मुस्लिम पॉपुलेशन। So victory in those areas also show. And now in the Gram Panchayat, district panchayats, that is Taluka Panchayat, and also in the municipalities, kal parson ke jo bhi result aaye hain, usme 100 se zyada, 106 Muslim candidates bhi jabardast jeet kar aaye hain BJP ke symbol mein. So if this is how it is, Gujarat mein jo Congress ke experiment tha, इन्वेस्टिगेशन एजेंसी को मिसयूज करते हुए समहाउ वी विल विन करना, उसको जनता ने उधर नकारा दिया। एंड यू विल फाइंड थ्रू आउट द कंट्री एंड इवन इन बिहार दिस अटेम्प्ट ऑफ द कांग्रेस विल बी कंप्लीटली डिफीटेड एंड कांग्रेस विल फेस द रियालिटीज, द ग्राउंड रियालिटीज। एंड इवन नाउ द अटेम्प्ट थ्रू द वेरियस इन्वेस्टिगेशन एजेंसीज विच इज गोइंग ऑन are clearly to divert the attention of the Indian public from their failures in the camp. Campaigning strategy is Congress ka itna failure ho chuka hai Bihar mein, wo sab aap bhi report kar rahe hain, aapko bhi jankari hai. So in order to divert attention from the continuous defeats that they have been facing, whether in Andhra Pradesh, where BJP candidate defeated the Pradesh Congress Committee chief second time within a matter of 3 years, whether it is the Bangalore Municipal Corporation, whether Chhattisgarh's recent by-election in Badgaon, whether it is Katlal, whether it is the Rajasthan Municipal Corporation Panchayat elections, continuously Congress is facing political defeat. And because of increased political frustration, they are doing everything to harass political opponents and make sure that they can continue in power. But you will see, and all of us are seeing, that they are being given sahi jawab by the janta of this country.
Ma'am, just a question. Apart from the OC and the CWG investigation, even there is an increasing focus even on the involvement of the Delhi government. What would the CWG have to say about that?
Well, we've said that the scope of the entire investigation and also looking at various levels of corruption, various levels of mismanagement of the Commonwealth Games will have to be completely investigated, and that's why we have said that there should be a joint parliamentary committee inquiry into this whole matter. बरकरार रख रहे हैं हमारी उम्मीद एनडीए सरकार वापस आएगी We'll get into the discussions about it. At the moment, we are definitely hopeful that we'll come with full and complete majority.
Thank you.
Thank you.